Hello there, it's Kriint and welcome to another speed build video, which is a 50 minute video, and it is quite crazy to think that this is a speed build. But yes, it's a speed build and it is speed as I normally speed videos, so you can just imagine how long it took me. So since it's such a long video, sit comfortably, grab yourself some popcorn, or pause the video and make some popcorn, and let's do this, and let's hope that I won't have to be in the midways because it's freaking 50 minutes. And I have never filmed such a big video again, and I hope that I won't have to do it in the near future because, let's be honest, I don't know what to say in 50 minutes. I mean, it's just a house. I could have split it up in two parts, but to be honest, I really didn't want to because that means that I would have to build either one less house or have a shorter video, build video a week, which would be a Harry Potter build video, the Wizardly World of Harry Potter, and I really want to build that, so I was like, let's do 1 hour build. So yeah, this house originally took me 14 hours and 50 minutes, 40 minutes, I don't really remember, and I cut many parts out, to be honest, because I was either sitting and doing the same thing over and over again, and by that I mean I was adjusting small details, or there was long pauses because I built that house when I was in holiday vacation. I had went to my parents' house for the holidays, and yeah, basically because I was at my hometown and I have lived there for like 3 years. I honestly didn't know, I knew people, but I hadn't keep contact with those people for like so many years, and it was like 10 days, so I have nothing to do. So I was extremely bored, and I don't have a huge family, so I was only me and my parents basically, and I was so bored and I was like, what can I do so the time can pass? And I was like, I know what I'm gonna do, I'm going to build for The Sims, I'm going to be so good, and I'm going to record so many builds for the whole month of January, so I won't have to do any builds when I'm back home, because I have midterms, I think, for my university, and you know, I had to study for those. But yeah, I only end up building this house, actually mansion. It was supposed to be a quick build, because this house is a house for, that's a lie. It was originally a house for the next model challenge that I was thinking that I'm gonna do. But then I was like, I don't wanna really do it, because even though I kinda watched it when I was younger, I'm not really into it, so I couldn't really make it entertaining. So it truly ended up just being a house build. And I really wanted to do it quick when I started it, because I was like, it's just for a video, and I really didn't care that much. Up to the time that I started making the bedrooms, as you can see, I'm making it pretty minimalistic. You will see that up to now, I haven't put any details, decorations and such. But weirdly, when I started getting into the bedrooms, and not so in that side of the house bedroom, but on the other side, I got into so much detail, into so much customization, and I was like, oh my god, yes. And basically, that will might sound strange for you, but I was basically doing each room as it was a room build. And what I mean by that is that, you know how you build a house or you find houses in the gallery if you don't build by yourself houses that are pretty simple. I mean, they're just in the bedrooms and in the bathrooms. They're just like way too normal and nothing very special. I mean, it's the same old stuff over and over. But if you go and search for a room, you will see some amazing things there. So, I don't know, as you can see, that's a pretty simple, and I think it's the most simple bench room in the entire house. So I was like, how can I make that interesting for me? And I thought, do you know how can I make it interesting? Of triggering each room specially. So that's what I did. Most of the rooms would look like their custom content. Actually, the bedrooms. Which, I don't know, I went very crazy with them. Which is kind of weird for me, because I've never done anything like that. And I'm thinking about, you know, putting the house in the gallery. It's already in the gallery, so if you want to download it, you can either click the link down in the description or you can click the link in the description down below, or you can just search my username in the gallery. Either way, you will find it. The link down below will take you to the web page of the gallery, and if you choose to download it or favorite it, it will appear the next time you open the game. So what I was saying? I don't remember. Oh my god. I really don't remember. Yeah, I think that I'm going to put a few of those rooms as separate rooms apart from the entire house. So I don't know, if you're just into one of the rooms, you can just download the room. Or if you like the entire house, you can get the entire house. Because to be honest, in a few of those rooms I spent so long, like, so long. Did I mention that this house has 8 bedrooms? 8 bedrooms? 4 bedrooms? And each and every bedroom has a double bed, so you can just fit 8 Sims. But, yeah, it's not the biggest house that I've ever built as it comes to, you know, amount of bedrooms and bathrooms. But it is definitely the biggest as it comes to size, since it is in the 64 by 64 lot in the Windenberg, as comes to items and time. Yeah. it has items from every single pack. Like, what? Yeah. I used even the latest one, Movie Hangout, which I just did the other day. You will see that the entire house is finished, but there's one room in the house that it's on the upper floor, which is empty. And when I was making it, I was like, what can I put there? What can I put there? I was like, maybe I will do a movie theater, because as I said, I started this build in late December, and I finished it this week. So, entirely finished it, just to be clear. So, when I left my hometown to go back on my place, I guess, I had completed the interiors. Nothing on the exterior, because, I don't know, I'm not that good on making the exterior look good. So, yeah. I had that room that was empty, so we're talking like January 3, and I had the idea of putting a cinema upstairs, like a home theater or something, a game room with get together, up until the time that they will release Movie Hangout stuff, and I was like, oh my god, that's perfect. And I was out when they actually released it. the day that they were going to release it. And I was like, come on, I want to go home. I have to play. Yeah, and basically I just ran back home and I downloaded the pack and I furnished the room upstairs. That you will see later, and it took me 2 hours. So I just want to put that out. This house, as I said, it has packs. It's in every single pack. And it has, as you can see from now, so much move objects on. So if you want to download it, you must have move objects on. Otherwise, I think it will look quite bad. I mean, yeah, I don't think that it will look half good because I used a lot of move objects and I tested the entire house. You will see later on a symbol up here out of the blue. And yeah, I used here for testing the entire house because I wanted to make sure that everything works. And that's something that I don't usually do. But because I have used so much move object, I want to make sure that everything worked. So this is the room that I started going a little bit crazy. I don't know. I've seen in a video of another streamer that you can post. Actually, I've seen it, I think, first in Deligracy, that you can push beds into the wall and they will work. And I was like, that's brilliant. I have never thought about that. And recently in James Turner's video, The Sims Supply, he actually used move objects to do the 6x6, 5x5 and all of that houses. And he basically put the beds into the wall. And I was like, since I can put the beds into the wall, I think that I can do something pretty good. So I was like, you know how few beds don't have the same frame. So they have some other frames and I was like, what can I do for it? And I didn't want to use custom content because I don't have custom content and I never had, because I think, even though I think the people who create the custom content do an extremely amazing job, but when other people try to download the house, the custom content don't appear in their game and it's like a blank space, so they must have the custom content, and I don't think that's nice. I think that's quite difficult for them. So I really wanted to make the house interesting in its room. So I started creating in the beds my own frames and I gave them my own shape. So it's like you have a custom content type of a bed without having custom content. And it looks very interesting. Okay, I'm sorry. I have the hiccups. Great time, right? Right, yeah. We only have 40 minutes left, so what a greater time to get the hiccups. So this room is entirely green, basically. Not entirely, it was based of green stuff because I used a lot of green, actually, because I don't know, I felt like with the candles and all of that stuff, candle resembles like Zen and all of that things, and I really liked it. So I kept using many greens around it and plants to give it that zen and nice look. And here is the bathroom for this room, sorry. But I cannot talk 50 minutes straight. Here's the bathroom for this room. I used again the same concept with greens and plants and zen feel to it. And I will have later on a room that will basically make this bathroom like the ensuite bathroom, because it's in every bedroom in this house has its own bathroom, and I really didn't like how open this one was, so I was like, what can I do to make it like that? So I basically did a weird room which is basically empty, but it works. Yeah, as I said, every bedroom has its own bathroom, and there are also two extra bathrooms. One next to the party area, I don't know, however you want to call it, and the other one right next to the kitchen. You will see it taking place later. I put the candles up to the waterfall because I was like, that's a weird spot there. Why this waterfall has this, I don't know how I'm gonna call it, rack? I don't know. It's like you can put stuff there. I was like, what can I put there? Maybe I will put stuff for the bathroom. And then I was like, candles, that's amazing. And here is the first cut will happen, because you know how the bathrooms have this, I don't know how I'm supposed to call them, windows, that basically glass things that separate the bathtub and the shower with the rest of the bathroom. Yeah, bathroom. So I wanted to create something like that, but it didn't really work the way I wanted it, and it took me so long to make it work because I wanted to be separated. So I used those windows and I tried to put a diagonal one, and it was so hard. So I was like, it was straight up 2 minutes video for you. So I was like, that's so boring, so let's just cut it off. And as you see, or you will see, I don't know, I didn't really notice. I will cut it off because you see, yeah, I didn't cut it off yet. You see this cap? I was so upset with this cap. I was like, this can't stay there. And I was like, no, it's okay. You know what? It's okay. It doesn't bother me. Then I was like, it bothers me so much though. And as you can see, the sink can still use the bathroom fine, but she clips just a bit. I will move them a bit back, so she won't clip in the windows while she changes. Yeah, that's the main reason that I basically did that. And at this part, I was so upset. I mean, in just a few moments, I was so upset because the columns can't go anywhere apart from the grids. And this wasn't happening in Sims 3 or 2, as far as I remember. So I was so mad because I really couldn't make it work the way I wanted it to work. So yeah, I used one of the pipes, as you can see here, a black pipe from Get Together, just so there was a gap between the large window and the diagonal window, and it really bothered me, but that was the best way, that the diagonal window could not have a weird gap, so I used this one. And here is of that bathroom. Basically, its bedroom has its own color and style, I guess. The first one was like all pink and girly. The second one was green and zen. This one was supposed to be artistic. That's why, I don't know, I love this bedding that has the Van Gogh painting, Starry Night. I just love it. But it didn't go with anything, I mean the frame, and I could not hide it so it would look normal, so it had to change, basically. And this is something like a bit of everything room, to be honest. It is the smallest bedroom of the house, because I kind of cheated a room for the two bathrooms, and I don't know, I did not have much space to work with. So I tried to make it to look at least interesting. So I put the whole wall width fence. Ow! Okay, I hurt myself. The whole wall width plant fence. How is it called? And I put a fireplace in. I really didn't know what I was doing. I just wanted to make it look interesting, basically. Yeah, there's that. You will see that I will change the bed in a bit, in just a few moments, because I didn't like the way it looked. I don't know, I think the house is ultra modern, So that was like, what's that? Why would you have that? Right. So I basically changed it. In just a bit. Yeah. What else about this room? What other details can I tell you? Oh yeah. Since I was in my parents' house, I'm the person who likes to be validated. I mean, if I'm making something, I'm not sure if I just like it or if other people like it. So I was just constantly bugging my boyfriend and sending him pictures. Do you like that? Do you like that? Do you like that? He's like, So I was trying to make this room a bit more beautiful, I guess. And he did not like the bed, as I didn't really enjoy it because I thought it was weird. So I used this one. I didn't want to use the same as the other bedroom, which is the cheapest bed. So I was like, what else can I use? And there was that it was kind of blue and it was really matching the whole thing. But I could not hide the stupid logs, and I thought they were looking so bad because, let's be honest, if the one didn't match the whole style for once, this didn't match the whole style for like 10, I don't know, I thought it looked horrible. So I was like, I can hide them like that, how does that look, do I like it? And then I was like, maybe if I put that over the sides, I think that looks better. So I was like, oh my god, yes, it does look better. So I started putting the whole thing there, and look, she can use it. And I was like so amazed by it, because she can just walk there like normally and sleep in the bed. So I was just so happy about it. And yeah, the annoying thing with that was the fact that I had to push back and forward the wall so it can work, because it was keep snapping in the wall. I think that was, those were lights. So I basically sized them up, and I don't know, I tried to do it like it was, how I'm supposed to call it? I don't know, like leather? Oh my god, sorry. You have definitely seen beds like that. I know that I have, at least. So yeah, I thought it looked quite good. And I went with it. I kinda liked it. And I should have probably cut that part out, because it's so boring to watch me doing the same thing over and over again. But I don't know why I cut it off. I did not cut it off. I should have. So this gave me an amazing idea for later on, which I'm not going to spoil it to you, because we have another half an hour. Hey, if you're still here, if you're still here, you're the champion. So yeah, I won't spoil it. So you know, you can see it by yourself. Here is the desk area, the office area, I guess. What I want to say for the office area. Since it was such a big house, sorry, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm talking straight for so many minutes. Since it was such a big house, I really wanted to have the desk area. So, you know, you can stay quiet and study or do your work at the computer. But the thing is that it was such a small space, so I had to make it work and look interesting with that small space. So I used this white and black painting from Get Together. No, it's not from Get Together, it's from, oh my god, how it's called? My brain freeze. Cool Kids and Stuff Pack. Yeah, I used them all around the house because I really liked them. I thought they gave an interesting note. As well, as you probably already seen, I used orange and yellow a lot. I don't know, I thought they gave a nice color to the place, because I used so much black. So I don't know. I thought it's a nice accent color. And as I was saying, I used this painting to basically give a pop of color there. And also as, I don't know, an accent color, because I didn't really want to paint the entire wall orange, but I wanted to have something orange there, apart from the chair, obviously. So I was like, that's a good idea, and I also did it in the pink bedroom. This house actually has not a single one like kids' bedroom or teen bedroom, but you can easily change any of those bedrooms into kids' one by adding, I don't know, a dollhouse or something. I don't really like doing kids' bedrooms, basically because, I don't know, I feel like you get quite, I'm supposed to call that, restricted. That's the word I'm looking for. Because if you have a kid's bedroom in the house, or even a toddler, I mean, no, baby? Probably baby. Yeah, they're called babies. A baby's room in the house, and you have no babies, so you're like, what am I gonna do with that bedroom? Or you will probably not download it. So I like to keep my rooms, you know, simple. So either you have a kid or a teenager or anything, you can still use that. And here's the second bathroom, extra bathroom that I was talking about, which is next to the kitchen, and anyone can basically use it. It still has this orange accent color, and oh my god, I kind of lost my voice there. Here is, I guess, the master bedroom. And here you will see so many cats, because I want to do something very interesting in this bedroom, and I want to sneeze right now, but I didn't really want to use the simple bed. I mean, the cheap one. Since this is the master bedroom, you know, having the cheap bed didn't really... I don't know. I didn't really like it because I was like, yeah, that's not nice. So I tried to use this bed, and basically try to make it look fine. And I cut that off because, oh my god, it took me so long to make this wall back there. I changed it so many times and just micromanaging everything. Even if there was just a small gap there, I had to change it, basically what I'm trying to say right now. So yeah, here's me again trying to change every little gap, and that's why there are these cats. Because it's pretty annoying to watch. I mean, I was quite bored doing it, so I can only imagine how you feel about it. Currently it's kind of a peachy color, but then it will change into blue. Because, I don't know, I think it kinda looked a bit better. Even though I kinda like the peach color, the only reason that I didn't go with the peach color was that there was no peach colored... I don't know how these are called from spa day, but these things that they're basically like lines for separating stuff in the floor, and I use them as a cover up into those, I guess you can call them leather boxes. I don't know, I thought it gave an interesting looking shape to the whole bedroom area. Because I don't know, it kind of looks like it's built in, and I really like that. Basically, I got inspired because my parents' bedroom looks kind of like that. So I was like, how can I do this in Sims? And that was the closest that I could actually do it. And I went with this little interesting design for the TV, because, you know, it's a master bedroom, so it must have a TV, right? And it also has its own walk-in closet, as well as, obviously, an ensuite bathroom, as I already told you. Oh my god, I will lose my voice after this video. You will see me, as I said, placing so many things with move objects. That's a good thing, because it looks unique. The bad thing is that I basically had to place them back on. Why, you ask? I was so smart, because as I already said, I'm not so good on doing the exterior. Oh my god, sorry. I'm not so good on doing the exterior. If it is to basically copy it from somewhere or get inspired from a build in real life, or generally making it look like interesting. So I was like, since I'm coming back soon home, I will leave it for that to that for my boyfriend to do, because he's quite the champ when it comes to that. In the interior, it's not that much, so I haven't thought of that, but yeah, when he was actually coloring it and changing few stuff, walls and stuff, everything got removed, so I had to place it back. So that was a fun thing to do, which I did not record for your sake and my sake. There is the ensuite bathroom, as I said. What I want to say about this bathroom, yeah, you saw a cut while I was placing the windows, because again, it was diagonal and it took me forever to actually make it look okay and not either clip in or have a gap. So I was like, nobody wanna watch that, so let's just remove that. Yeah, that's an interesting looking bathroom. I use those blue stuff in their normal size and as they're supposed to be, as they were supposed to be used, I guess, in the bathroom and not in the bedroom, the way that I use them in the air. And here is when I got back home, and as you can see, yeah, he's doing the exterior, and you will slowly see stuff, a window popping and saying, 5 items move to inventory, 3 items move to inventory, and even seeing that, it kind of breaks my heart. Because, thank God that I was sending him all the time screenshots, and I was like, hey, do you like that? Hey, do you like that? Hey, how does that look like? Because otherwise, to be honest, I did not remember where I placed those. Because I did the pink bedroom, like, what, about 25, 26 of December, and when he's doing the exterior was probably 5 of January, so it's 10 days later, and yeah, I could not really remember what I was doing or where I had placed all of those items. It was totally, I think, 36 items that got moved. So yeah, that was something else, and you will see so much mouse moving, because he was like, this will be there, this will be there, do you like that? And I'm like, I don't care, just do it. So yeah, that was interesting. And the exterior isn't anything so special, I guess, with it. The lot was so big that I really didn't know what to do with it, because the house wasn't that big for a 64 by 64 lot, but because I really wanted it to be in the island of get together Windenburg, I don't know if the island has a name, it did not fit in the rest of the lots, and that was the only lot that it can basically fit in the island. Again, I don't know about, I guess, it's not Sunset Valley, oh my god. What is the first? Willow Creek. Okay. That was a close one. In Willow Creek. I don't know. I basically just wanted it there and I built it there. So yeah, you will see the exterior doesn't have that much. Basically what I'm trying to say. It's very simple, quite minimal, and I think it works. It looks quite good. Those little squares that you see besides the pool, it's kind of like a pool house. I don't know exactly the definition of a pool house. I searched it online. Here's the items being removed, and here's my heart just breaking. Oh my god. Yeah, it took me quite a while to put them back. What I was saying? Yeah, I don't know the exact definition of a pool house. I searched it up. It was quite confusing because it was many things. Like, it could be an entire house, or it could be just a bar or whatnot. Okay, so it's basically a bar and a grill area, and there's a jacuzzi. Jacuzzi? No. How is it called? Oh, I don't remember. Hot tub? No, it's not a hot tub. What I'm saying? I don't remember, sorry. Something hot. Steam? It's steam? I don't know. Okay, I feel like I need it. So I wanted to place that in the house. And here things again being removed. And again my heart breaks. I want to place that inside the house, and you probably saw it. I tried to fit it where the second bathroom of the house, extra bathroom of the house is. But it didn't really fit, so I was like, you know what? The pool house would be a good idea to actually fit it in. And that's what it ended up having there. There's also a fireplace. How is it called? The exterior fire thingy? I don't know. And yeah, there's not much in the back side of the house, I guess. Oh yeah, there's a hot tub as well. But yeah, as I said, it's quite simple. I don't know, but it looks good, and I think that's the important thing about it. Also, the funny thing is how she wears that little stupid hat of hers in her head. That was Christmassy, basically. It was the character that I was playing. Actually, I have designed for a Christmas. Designed? Created for a Christmas play, let's play, that I was doing by myself. So I don't know, it was the first one that was around in my gallery, and I don't know, I plopped here. Also, you can see that in the start of the video I have the snow mode, and then I suddenly don't have it, which is interesting. But yeah, I removed it because I removed all my mods. I don't remember why. So yeah, this is how it looks without the snow mode. I don't know how it looks with the snow mode. The screenshots are like normal, because it might be January, but it's not that cold here, so yep. I was trying to do something interesting for the pool house. So I did not create it like a house. I did that thing in the room that I don't know its name. And I tried to make it like open, and I placed that thing from luxury part, I think it's called, as another column, because I don't know, I thought it looked good. And you will see later on the screenshots, which we still have time for them. Yeah, you will see that I changed the lighting. I think that the lighting, when you change the lighting, it stays like that. So I don't know, I changed the lighting in many places to look cooler, and you will see it in the screenshots. The bar area has blue and magenta colored lights, and I think it looks very cool. And here we skipped forward because I was trying that. Trying to do something creative, I guess, with a hot tub. I mean, so it won't be just a hot tub there. And I was like, what can I do? What can I do? And that was basically the only thing that came into my mind, putting those glass shady things. But I don't know, it took me so long, because originally I put it 5 there, and they really didn't look that good. And I was trying to figure out how to make it look good with 5, and then I was trying to make it look good with 4, and it took me so long, and it was so boring to watch, so again, I cut it all off. You're welcome. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so I'm back. And I don't remember what I was saying. Because when you film a 50-minute video and you got a 20-minute phone call, you do not expect to remember what you were saying. I don't know. So, hello. Did I say hello? I think I did. I'm doing the exterior. I don't know what I was saying. I'm sorry. I hope I did not say something important. I probably didn't. Because let's be honest, I'm talking for 40 minutes. What can I say that it would be important? So I'm doing the exterior and I used those little, I don't know their name, things that came with spray that they're put into the fountains to actually create like a split level higher thing in the entrance and entryway. I don't know. Because I don't know, I thought it was boring to actually... I wanted to be symmetrical. I wanted the fountain to be the same height and width and everything in both of the ways. And I was like, what I'm gonna put over there? And I don't know, that was the best solution that I basically came up with. And here's a weird lead. I was so upset with it. Because as you can see, no matter what I put in these two tiles, it didn't show up. And it was not because the land wasn't flat, because that's a glitch that happens sometimes. The land is flat there and you can see that the land is flat there. It's just that, I don't know, all the fences that I put there was basically non-existent. And I was so upset about it. And here is me trying to make something interesting, I guess, on the exterior. I don't know, I was trying my best to make it look good, basically. And I made a little garden area here with two of those bonsai plants and a little elephant, because I kind of love elephants, to be honest. And I used this statue to create more, I don't know... to have something, you know, on the exterior rather than just green... well, that's something I forgot to do. Terrain painting. I actually did it, but I don't think that it's either in the screenshots or in the video. So that's a problem. And here's me trying to make, again, something interesting. I used those bushes and those flowers, and I basically cut it off because I was alternating two bushes and one flower through the entire perimeter of the house, and it was not interesting to watch. I mean, come on, I would keep doing the same thing over and over again, so I cut it off. You will see it kind of better in the screenshot. You won't be able to see much. And as you can already see, I've done almost everything from the exterior, but there's still one room to be built, the movie room. And that's because, again, I have finished everything and I was waiting for the back. Oh my god, I'm so stupid, I didn't do terrain paintings before I take the screenshots. Also, during the screenshots, I don't know if you will be able to spot in any screenshots, a few wall paintings were wrong. So I had to retake a few screenshots. I don't know if I left any screenshots. Terrain paintings? Wall paintings. You will see that after I'm done building this room, that the wall paint on the exterior is totally different. It's like white. And it's like, why is that there? So yeah, that happened in the screenshots. So yeah, here is me trying to make a decent, modern room. What? Movie room, I guess. Theater? Movie theater. And I wanted it to be modern. So I was really, really struggling to make it interesting. And I don't know, I think it's very minimalistic. It doesn't have that much the way it turned out. Looking in photos in the internet, on the internet, I saw that the modern ones are basically have Either few big couches or separated like nooks. Two couches, two chairs together, or something like that. And I don't know, I just got inspired from normal theaters, home theaters, normal, and I mean old ones, kind of like the old style, that, you know, when you go into a theater room, there's a raised area. Because obviously if you sit in the same height as the other person, you won't be able to see so good in the screen. So I don't know, I was like, those can be decorative, right? And I was like, but you will see later that I will replace the couches with four chairs from Spa Day, the massage, because they look very comfortable, basically. And I was like, only four chairs, though? That doesn't even have eight for the whole sim, the whole household. So I was like, what can I do? What can I do? And I wanted it to be raised. And the amazing thing is that what I did actually works. It's three times raised, and it's amazing. You will see something totally obscure that you haven't seen before. I don't know, I was quite proud of it. I cut it most of the part off while I was doing it. You will see here, I was like, that's okay, right? But again, I did not enjoy how the couches looked there. So I was like, I will put it that in, maybe if there are less tiles of that stuff, I don't know how it's called, maybe the same can go there. But she couldn't. So I was like, how can I make that work? What if this thing is only on the sides? Can't she just basically climb into the couch, I guess? Because in real life, you will be able to sit in there, but not in sim life. Right now, it's two times up, higher than the ground level, I guess. And I was like, maybe I can put a rug there, but the rug, I don't know, when you rise up, disappears. I didn't know that. And yeah, I don't know. I was trying to make it interesting, as I said. So I thought I should put something back there, right? Because this doesn't make any sense. I was like, yeah, light? Right, curtains. And it took me so long, so long to put the curtains in the right place. And I don't know, I think that kind of creates a separate room, but in the same time, it's the same room as the rest of the house. So it's kind of an open plan, which was interesting. And I put those bars behind it, so, you know, it won't look stupid. And it was like it was supposed to be there. So there's that. Here is me testing if she can sit, and she obviously couldn't sit. And when I put that into the corner, she could sit, and I was like, oh my god, that's awesome. And I tried that, and she could sit there as well, and I was so happy. So I ended up doing kind of like the same thing that I did with the third bedroom of the house. And this, as you can see, is three times up, and she can sit normally, and it was so awesome. I was so happy. See, she can sit, and it's three times higher than the ground level. And I was like, oh my god, that's amazing. Imagine the things that you can do. I was so happy. And here are the screenshots. There are so many screenshots that you can see. Here's basically the exterior of the house, the entrance of the house. Yeah, there's so many screenshots. The house is so big, so, you know, I had to take so many screenshots. Here's the little statue. The kitchen, dining and living area. I put the, how is it called? Aquarium? No, I don't know what I'm saying. You know when I'm saying those, so I won't stress about it. The little book nook area that you can study. That's the entrance to the bedroom and the party area, and that's the first separate bathroom, that's the party area, I guess, if you want to call it that way, which is pretty orange and yellow. Here's the pink bedroom, which is quite the girliest of them all, obviously. The very luxurious pink bathroom. and its own walk-in closet. I mean, it's not really a walk-in closet, but you get what I'm saying. Here is the other part of the house, the second bedroom, the green zen one, as I called it, and yeah, the bathroom of it. Generally, there are way too many screenshots for you to actually watch. Yeah, I know it's a big house, but not that big because it doesn't have so many rooms. I really hope you liked it. I will leave you with a screenshot because, let's be honest, I've been talking for the last 50 minutes. And if you watch the whole video, then you're truly the champion, even if you pause it and show it another day. I really hope you enjoyed it. It took me so long to actually make it, but I'm so proud of how it turned out. Please, please, please leave your comments down below of how you thought about the house. It would make me so happy, so, so happy. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I really hope I gave you some building ideas, I guess, of what you can do, because, you know, I kinda went over the top with this build. Anyways, I really hope you liked it. If you want to download it, as I said before, there's a link in the description down below, or you can just search my username in the gallery, which is the exact same as here. I honestly hope you will have an amazing day, and I don't know, please leave also your suggestions of what else would you like to see next. I will see you in the next video. Anyways, thank you so much. Have an amazing day and take care. Bye.